Do you know this situation? You want to machine a relatively tight area using a ball end cutter in a three-axis operation. So you make your settings, choose the surfaces, processing strategies, and so on, generate the operation, but then you realize that not all areas have been processed. Why? Because the tool is clamped too short, and in case of application, it could also lead to a collision. What are we doing here? Sure, tilt the tool axis until there's enough clearance. The question is, what's the fastest way? You can do a lot with vectors, or are there any additional options here? My name is Heinrich Flaum, and in today's quick tip from JANUS Engineering, I'll be showing you what the so-called view direction is actually all about.
So, here's our workpiece. Now, I want to mill this area here in this corner with the fixed axis guiding curves operation, using three-axis machining. So if I double-click in there now, I can already see the selection I made. Here, under Specify Cut Area, we can see exactly this section. As pattern type, I have selected Morph Around Mid-Pass here. And the cut pattern obviously is set as helical here. When I create these specific operations, this notification appears. It specifically states the following. The tool is clamped so shortly that my tool holder would inevitably collide with the workpiece if it continued to move forward. That's why Siemens NX cuts out these collision paths right here. So, how can I help myself out of this tricky situation now? Well, by simply tilting my tool axis at the appropriate angle. For that, I go to Access and Avoidance. And up here in Tool Axis, I now say Specify Vector instead of CM Axis. And for Specify Vector, we now have several options here. For example, Invert Vector, True Points, Curve Axis Vector, and so on. We're now interested in the second to last option, which is called View Direction. If I select this now, the tool axis will be set according to how I currently view the workpiece. So I select this now, View Direction, and generate the operation again. We see this beautiful tool path in front of us. If I place the tool precisely here now, we see that I'm standing exactly perpendicular to the tool. So the tool has, well, for its tool axis, exactly selected the view that I had just taken myself. And if I turn it around a bit here, we can already see how the tool finishes machining this geometry in three axes. I confirm with OK. I also turn on the machine, because I want to simulate this toolpath again in the NC text context. Click on Simulate Machine. And once the NC text has been created here, I can now also simulate the tool by pressing play. The tool will now be changed, and here we can already see the three-axis machining of the area. So here we see X, Y, and Z.
All right, now we know how to quickly align the tool axis according to my view on the part, making sure every adjustment is precise and suited for efficient machining operations. The great thing about this particular method is that we're not just limited to tool axes here. All coordinate systems can be realigned using the same reliable method as before. I hope you enjoyed this video and that you can use this trick in your everyday life. We appreciate more inquiries in our comment section and, of course, a subscription, so you don't miss out on more videos like this one. And if you'd like to watch another one of our numerous NX videos, feel free to click on one of these two suggestions right here for you. See you next time. Bye.
Let's make it real. JANUS Engineering.